To discuss South Africa's fixed income outlook for the year and macroeconomic factors that affect investments in this space, we're joined in studio by Mamokete Lijane, fixed income and credit analyst at RenCap. Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.
Well, let's start with the fixed interest environment. It's a wide arena. What is holding your interest at the moment?
There are a number of things that are holding my interest at the moment. I think the key thing for me is the disparities between the fundamentals and the risk. So you've got the risk environment that's highly messy, a lot of uncertainty around the European debt situation, and then you've got the domestic issues, which are the fundamentals. And often those two go in opposite directions.
Was there some relief in the market today when the Spanish bond auction was fully subscribed?
I think you started seeing that from earlier on in the week already, and to some extent in the latter part of last week, where market sentiment around Spain and how the European debt situation as it relates to Spain is going to unfold, there was more confidence that you weren't going to see any stresses coming from that, and the relief started coming through in the market, and you saw the pricing respond accordingly. Of course, we also had the announcement from Citibank late last week, or early this week, on Monday actually, where they said they indicated that they would be increasing the weighting of South African bonds within the index. And that, again, also helped the market somewhat. So after having a bit of a rough time 2 to 3 weeks ago, the market seemed to be settling in again.
Nahan, I genuinely see you as an equities man, because we're always discussing equities. How do you feel about the fixed income environment, fixed interest environment?
Well, the international environment, I'm very skeptical about. I think that there's a huge mispricing internationally. If you look at the States and especially at Europe, I don't think we have that as much in South Africa. But I must say, I would much prefer at this stage, in any case, in South Africa as well as abroad, to look at corporate bonds rather than government bonds.
Would that be a fair view?
I'd be inclined to go with Han on that issue. I think what we have at the moment is incredibly overpriced or expensive government bond markets, and that's a global phenomena. So you've got that dynamic playing out. It does not necessarily mean that they will reprice in the near term over the next month or two or three even, maybe not even six. But you do have the dynamic where yields are extremely low, and we all believe that the next move is going to be higher. So if you're going to be playing the bond story at the moment, you'd rather have some exposure to the cycle, some exposure to the up cycle that we expect to see in the latter part of the year, maybe into next year as well. And the best way to do that, to get the combination of that equity and bonds, is to go the corporate route.
Is to go the corporate bond route.
Yeah.
Now, how do you go about choosing an appropriate corporate bond?
In South Africa, unfortunately, it's not that simple, simply because there aren't that many of
which
them.
Which is why I asked the question. So exactly. It's just limited supply. You've got to go for what you can get.
Exactly. And if you look at the spreads on our bond yields, they're quite tight. There's not that much more yield really to pick up there. But it's still worth something. If you can pick up 150 to 200 basis points over government, it's worth something. But for an individual investor, it'll be very difficult to enter the market. And for the institutional investor, the guys that want to be invested are already invested. So to try and pick something up on the secondary market is quite hard. So you probably want to go in at the auctions and that kind of thing. And that's what a lot of guys are doing.
How do you feel about the inflationary environment in South Africa at the moment? Obviously, CPI coming out yesterday is 6% below expectations. Most economists saying, though, that this is just a temporary pullback. It's going to tick up again. Do you feel that is correct?
You know, the inflationary environment in South Africa is a cyclical story like any other. So we have this uptick in inflation at the moment. You should expect that, barring some external shock, so unless you have something happening on the oil price or maybe the currency, you should not expect to see a massive push in inflation over the next, say, 12 months. But beyond that, then maybe your
do you believe that it's going to stabilize at around the 6% level?
I sort of think from where we are, you're probably going to go a bit lower. You might have a little bit of an uptick in the near term, but over the next 6 months or so, possibly coming off again before you start seeing it reverse up again. My belief, and I don't necessarily, not everybody agrees with me on this, is that the inflationary environment in South Africa, when it comes to inflation shocks. So for inflation to really kick up away from the 6% to 5.5%, 6.5% sort of range, you'd have to see something happening on the currency side. That's what we've typically seen, and I would expect it to come from that. So I'm saying if the rand doesn't blow up, inflation will remain well anchored.
Hein? In terms of, obviously, it's also a view on the rand because of its impact on inflation. But do you think that inflation is going to settle around these levels? Do you take cognizance of it?
Yes, no, you definitely have to. But on the other hand, I'm very careful to make any forecasts on the currency. I believe Greenspan once said that the most reliable way to forecast a currency is to flip a coin.
Do you do that often in the office?
I mean, all of us know how difficult it is to forecast. So we always say, well, you can have a forecast on the rent, but you're always going to be wrong. So you know you're going to be wrong, yeah. Right? It's very difficult to forecast. But unfortunately, you cannot forecast things like inflation or have a view on inflation if you don't have some sort of view on the rent.
Yeah.
So we have to have a view.
You've got to have something to plug into your model.
Some view, you know?
Let's move to interest rates, and the general consensus is that we will see interest rates going up from these levels, but I see most economists now saying that that's only going to happen in 2013.
Yeah.
Is that your view?
That's the sort of view that we also adopted. We've always said it's probably going to be later rather than sooner, and that's because inflation is well under control. Growth is coming up, it's recovering, but it's not great, and we're looking for a slowdown this year relative to last year. So in that environment, the Reserve Bank is probably not going to be that keen to move on rates. So some of you that we have.
Hein, anything that you want to drill down into while we've got Mamokete in studio?
Yeah, Mamokete referred just now to it's difficult for the man in the street to get invested into that market directly, and it is virtually impossible for them to get involved in that. So therefore, they should go for particular unit trust funds that are really that have they are very good fund managers out there that is in that market and very effective. And I'm specifically thinking now of Dave Foord's stable fund, for instance, where Dave Foord is a strong investor rather in the corporate bonds than in the government bonds.
That would be salient advice.
Another one that I can think of that does that kind of strategy is Future Growth. They always had much more of an exposure to credit.
Yeah.
And I think Prudential as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I agree with both of those.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for your time. That's it. That was Mamokete Lijane, fixed income and credit analyst at RenCap.